Hey guys, what is up? It is Gaming Master here, and today I'm going to be giving you an update about what is going on with the hurricane here, because this hurricane is not playing it friendly at all. So here's the first piece of evidence here. And also, I found this out in a live stream where they're showing evidence about many things on the radar. So check out the vorticity of this hurricane here. Look at this. You see how furious that thing is? And look at how fast that thing moves and how much wind power that thing has. Like, that hurricane has high wind power. And then, as you see, when the hurricane gets up near somewhere, I believe in Canada, is where it's gonna completely die off. And also, take a look at this thing. I'm gonna pause it right here. So as you can see, this is the direction of the hurricane here. So as you can see right here, it's at a C1 and it goes straight up the East Coast. And also, it's gonna hit states like North Carolina, Virginia, Maryland, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, New York, New Hampshire, and Vermont dead on. Like, look at this hurricane. It's gonna be a dead hit on those eight states because of the direction that it's going. And also, here's the legend of colors, and this is with rain. So if the color is green, that means it's 0.1 to 0.5, which means it's less than an inch of rain. If you're in the blue, that means 0.5 to 1.5 inches of rain. If the color is purple, that means 1.5 to 2 inches of rain. If the color is red, that means 2 to 3 inches. And if the color is orange or yellow, that means 3 to 7 inches or higher, because as you can see, it says 3 to 7 plus. And since it has the plus sign right here, that means that it could be even higher. And the problem here is that you see the hurricane here. There's orange inside of here, which means that these states are going to get hit by the purple, the red, and the orange here. And also, if you look over here, you can see the analog of the hurricane here and how much rain is expected to be produced. So that means that these states that are in those three colors have a chance of getting hit by 12.5 inches of rain tomorrow, which is very scary. And I don't know how the hurricane is doing this when it's at a C1. It's seriously at a C1, and yet it's causing this much damage. Also, let's go to the next scene here. So as you can see, the hurricane is just passing through Charleston. Also, it's also passing through Georgetown right here. Now, as you can see by the analog here, the hurricane is currently hitting Wilmington right here, because as you can see, Wilmington is getting hit by the eye. And also, even Florence and Rockfish are getting hit, but they're getting hit by the left edges of the hurricane. And also, New Bern in North Carolina is also just starting to get hit. And also, you can even see those high wind effects, which are even going to hit Raleigh, North Carolina as well. As you can see, the eye is just passing through Charleston. Now, here's an analog about the wind here. So, as you can see by tomorrow, when the hurricane hits Pennsylvania and Maryland here, it's going to be 65 miles per hour, and it's still going to be C1. Now, when it gets up to like New York, Vermont, and New Hampshire, it's going to be down to 50. And then when it gets to the low spots up here, it's going to be 35 and 30. And then once it gets right there, that's where the hurricane is going to die off by that point. So yeah, the hurricane is going to be doing a direct hit on those eight states that I mentioned earlier in the video. And then if you take a look here, you can see a whole bunch of colors here. Now here's the legend for these colors. Also, I'll give you this legend first. So this was from 9 p.m. So the winds of the hurricane are 85 miles per hour right now. The moving speed is north and northeast at 18 miles per hour. Also, the Also, the press is 988 millibars, and then the location is 33.1 north and 78.8 west. Also, I'll give you the legend of the colors. So, if the color is green or blue, that means safe. If the color is white, that means it's even. If the color is yellow, that means slight warning. If the color is purple, that means severe thunderstorm warning. If the color is light red, that means hail warning. And if the color is dark red, that means tornado warning. And also, I even looked up a lot of analogs for this storm, and I realized that depending on how bad the hurricane is going to hit these areas, that also depends on, because I looked at the analog for Pennsylvania right here, and Pennsylvania has a chance of getting hit by an F5 tornado, which is bad. Also, New York has a chance of getting an F3 tornado, and Maryland has a chance of getting hit by an F4, which is not good. It's all because of the C1. And then even look at this. So as you can see, the hurricane down here, now this is where I'm talking about. So see how it went right up the coast of Florida, but then it turned right here, and now it's just on the coast of South Carolina. And then once it zooms out here, now here's the legend for this as soon as it zooms out. So as you can see, if the color is yellow, that means thunderstorm watch. If the color is pink, that means hurricane watch. If the color is blue, that means thunderstorm warning. And if the color is red, that means hurricane warning. And as you can see, most of the East Coast is blue right now, which means that's a thunderstorm warning. But Maine and part of New Hampshire are in the yellow, which means they're just in a thunderstorm watch right now. And also, there's a little bit of red down here, and red means hurricane warning, so that's not good. Now we're going to see the wind speeds in the next photo. So take a look at the wind speeds here, guys. Take a look at the wind speed. Look at all of these colors. Now I'm going to give you the legend about the colors. So, if the color is dark green, that means 10%. If it's light green, 20%. If it's very light green, 30%. If it's yellow, 40%. If it's light yellow, 50%. If it's light orange, 60%. If it's orange, 70%. If it's red, 80%. If it's dark red, 90%. And if it's purple, it's 100%. And the problem here is that North Carolina, part of Virginia, and the tip of Maryland right here are in the purple, so they have a 100% chance of a thunderstorm wind probability right here. And also, you can even see that Boston is somewhat in the red, but it's mostly in the yellow, which still has some 60, 70, and 80% chances. And you can see New York and New Jersey are both in the red and dark red, which means they're at 80 and 90%. This is just insane, guys. I am honestly shocked. Also, I'm going to show you another dialogue, so I'll come back when I have that pulled up. Alright, so I just looked up the wind speed probabilities here, and I'm going to be looking up all of these. So, to start off, take a look at this. So, as you can see, this is basically like what you just saw in the video about the wind speeds and the thunderstorm probabilities here. So as you can see, not only does that purple part go through a few states, but as you can see, it also goes through the tip of Maryland right there and even through New Jersey nearly almost. And the purple part even gets somewhat near Boston, Massachusetts, but the purple part is not really near Rhode Island and Connecticut. Rhode Island and Connecticut are still in the red, though. So let's look at the next one, which is arrival time of winds. So as you can see, but the wind here does not look good. So as you can see, the hurricane is right there. It's just entering North Carolina and moving out of South Carolina. So as you can see, by 2 a.m., that's when the wind speeds are going to start expanding. And then by 8 a.m., the wind speeds really start to expand. I mean, look at how far the wind speeds expand here. Like, just look at how far that expands. And also, let's look at the next one, which is wind history. Now, this is the entire direction of the hurricane here. So, as you can see, tropical storm is yellow. Hurricane plus force wind slabs of Elizik from advisories 1 through 28 is red. So, as you can see, most of it is yellow. But the hurricane started right here. Right here is where the hurricane started. And then it went across the Caribbean right here. Then it started hitting Florida. And then it turned and went up to start hitting the tip of South Carolina. And now it's starting to hit into North Carolina, which is bad. Which means that it's almost to Virginia as well. On to the next one, which is warnings and cone interactive map. Now take a look at this, guys. Look at how far this hurricane is expected to go up the East Coast. So as you can see, hurricane is right there at a C1. And then as you can see, the hurricane goes up a far way up the coast because it literally starts from here. Like it starts from here, then goes right up the East Coast all the way up here. Which is really scary. And now, let's look at the static images here. So take a look at this. So it says by Wednesday and Thursday at 8 a.m. and 8 p.m. is when the hurricane will be at low speeds. And the hurricane stops right there. Right there is where the hurricane stops. So it's starting here at a C1 because right where that X is with the red around it, that's where the hurricane currently is right now. And also, that blue stuff, that blue line that you see right there along the coast, though, that's for wind advisories. So basically, the entire East Coast is under a severe wind advisory. And it's also under a severe wind warning. Now, look at the surface wind here. So take a look at this. So you see the line right there? Also, take a look at the legend here. So as you can see, if the color is pink, that means hurricane watch. If the color is yellow, that means tropical storm watch. If the color is red, that means hurricane warning. If the color is blue, that means tropical storm warning. If the color is dark red, that means hurricane force. If the color is dark yellow, that means tropical storm force. So yeah, and take a look at the colors. So as you can see, there is red, and red is for a hurricane watch, and you can also see yellow, but that's actually dark yellow right there, and dark yellow is a tropical storm force, which means that there's going to be a lot of forced winds right near South and North Carolina. And then there's also blue along the entire East Coast, which is a tropical storm warning, so that means that the entire East Coast is under a tropical storm warning right now. And look at how much of that blue is over Maryland and New Jersey. That's not good. And then look at the key messages here. So I'm going to bring you down to the radar. So take a look at this. You got two images here about how much rain and force that's going to be. That's going to be some really insane force right there within the wind. Now let's look at the next one, which is Menzies Claves, or however you pronounce that. These are just readings. Now let's look at the storm surge inundation. By the way, I'm tracking the storm by doing this. Yes, I want to continue. All right, so take a look at this, guys. So as you can see, this is what it looks like, and the hurricane is somewhere in there. It doesn't say where it is, pretty much, but still, as you can see, the hurricane is definitely going to be passing up the East Coast, and It's gonna be hitting a lot of those areas. I can already guarantee that. Now let's look at the next one, which is Storm Surge Watch slash Warning. Now let's look at this. I don't need to see that. All right, so now as you can see on the East Coast, the hurricane is actually gonna split here because it actually goes two different directions and puts the whole East Coast in a dangerous situation, which is not good. And then let's look at the peak surge. And like I said, I'm gonna be showing all of these. So look at the peak surge here on the map. So as you can see, the hurricane is located right there, and it's gonna be moving pretty fast up the coast. Like, see, the hurricane is even gonna slightly hit Delaware Bay right there, because it's actually gonna be hitting near Dover, Delaware as well. And then it also goes up to New Jersey, and it even reaches Connecticut for some reason. That's the Vineyard Sound of 1 to 3 feet. It says Narragansett Bay, Buzzards Bay, and Vineyard Sound, 1 to 3 feet of the peak of this hurricane. Now let's look at the rainfall potential. The rainfall potential is not looking good. Take a look at this rainfall. So as you can see, most of it is light green and dark green. Now here's the legend. If the color is light green, that means 1 to 2 inches. If the color is dark green, that means 2 to 4 inches. If the color is yellow, that means 4 to 6 inches. If the color is orange, that means that it's 6 to 10 inches. If the color is red, that means 10 to 15 inches. If the color is pink, that means 15 to 20 inches. And if the color is black, that means 20 inches or higher. Now most of it is light green and dark green, which means it's only between 1, 2, and 4 inches. But some of it is yellow, which means it's a potential 4 to 6 inches. But then there's a little patch of orange right there, which means that's 6 to 10 inches right there, as you can see. Which means that's gonna be a lot of rainfall that the hurricane is expected to produce. For along the to produce along the East Coast. Then look at the flash flooding potential here. So as you can see by the flash flooding potential, if the color is green, that means 5% Martigal. If the color is yellow, that means 10% slight. If the color is red, that means 20% moderate. And if the color is pink, that means 50% high. And also, as you can see, this part is green, and all the rest of the outside is green, but then the middle part is yellow, and the eye of the storm, where the direction it's going, is in the red. And the worst part is the top of Maryland right there, right underneath Pennsylvania, and the bottom of Pennsylvania are in the red, which means we're at a 20% moderate risk. And I also realized that, look at these two maps. See how the hurricane is expected to produce a direct hit like that? That's what I mean, guys. That's what I mean. Also, a direct hit here. And then the last one is a tornado potential, which is probably a new map. So this is a new map here. So as you can see, the hurricane is over here, and you could see that little red line there. And if the state is in that red circle, that means that it's a tornado warning. And also, Maryland is somewhat in that circle, which means that Maryland is now under a tornado warning. It's not just under a watch anymore. Now Maryland is both under a tornado watch and a tornado warning, and there's a possible chance of an F4 tornado producing in Maryland because the hailstorm is expected to be really strong. And since the hailstorm is going to be really strong, according to this, that's why there's a possible chance of an F4 tornado being produced in Maryland. And since Pennsylvania is getting a little bit worse right here, that's why Pennsylvania has a chance at an F5. And since New York is not really that, it's not really getting hit that much, there's a possible chance of an F3 tornado hitting New York, but it depends on if a tornado actually forms or not. Because a tornado might not form. It might just be severe rain, but nobody knows yet. So yeah, this hurricane is a deadly hurricane, guys. I'm not joking. This is a really deadly hurricane. Like, I never expected the hurricane to be this deadly. So yeah, that wraps it up for the update about the hurricane. So anyways, this is me, Gaming Master, over and out.